Hello and what's going on, guys? And Rage here, back in the video. And guys, in this video I'm not kind of well, but I'm still doing this video because my exams are over finally. And I hate it when I get sick after the exam. So you have done all the hard work and now you're sick, so you can't have the fun. So let's just forget this topic and further to start this video. Everything is difficult. Help me help you. So guys, in this video we'll be talking about the best ways to earn money in Dragon Ball Final Stand. So this is kind of complicated, but once you get the hang of it, it becomes really easy. Oh my god, I really hate when these rallies do those firework thingies. There are all those rallies going ahead. Actually, there's a park next to my house, and this time only there are a lot of rallies and stuff, so fireworks and kind of things, you get it. So what else is going to tell us the best ways to earn money in Dragon Ball Final Stand? So there are two good ways to earn money. One is for low level players and one is for high level players. The third way is the kind of average. It's the quest thingy. You just find and do daily quests, that's it. But in my ways, the first two ways which I'm going to tell you are the best. So the first way is TOP, or Tournament of Power or Top. So what happens here is that once you have won the tournament, you get the option to either get money, either get prestige. And there's one more option, I forgot that. I think it's the level cap. You can get rid of the level cap. So yeah, if you do the top, you can, I think, almost 100,000 or 1 million zenny or something like that. I think it's 1 million zenny. So once you have completed the top, you can just talk to Zeno. Zeno will give you 1 million zenny if you choose it. And I would recommend, if you're already prestige 1, don't get prestige again, because prestige 2 has only Master Ultra Instinct, and I find it when you would compare the Ultra Instinct and Master Ultra Instinct, Master Ultra Instinct is worse than Ultra Instinct. Now you might say that you are an idiot, but I'm not an idiot. I'm saying it sensibly. I've witnessed it. So what happens is, in Ultra Instinct you have good stats, but when you get Master Ultra Instinct, the stats barely change, like 15 or 16 stat points change. You must say, wow, that's a lot, but I find it really useless. I won't just do it for one form and only 15 to 16 stat points. I find it useless. Plus, when you use it after it's over, those chunky effects, and you lose far more health than you lose in Ultra Instinct. So I prefer you don't take prestige. Okay, I'm getting out of the topic. So the topic was how to earn money. So the second option or the thing is that you can grind. So now grinding is the best method, I find it. I almost got 20,000 in 1 or 2 hours. And it's really, I find it really good. The best grinding spots, I've made a video about it. If you want to go and see it, you can check it out. I'll leave a link in the description. But the next thing that I'm going to tell you, actually, let me go on grinding. Let me tell you what is grinding and how to do it on the very best. So grinding technically means that you are going to an NPC and killing it again and again. It doesn't mean to, and then extracting the experience and things It doesn't mean to spam kill someone. It's not grinding. I don't know what that is. I just find it stupidity. So, grinding legitly is just stats. And its technical meaning is harsh and grading. So you just are kind of extracting or playing with the NPCs and getting a lot of money. So grinding is, it is in different ways. So you can do it by quest, you can do it by killing NPCs, but killing NPCs is limitless and you can get a lot of zenny, a lot of experience. I'm level 250, as 257, I got to 258 in 1 or 2 hours. So that's a big thing. I was grinding on Earth, so that's a big thing if you're on 257 and you directly jump up to 258 by straight up grinding. So mostly grinding is not meant for experience, it's done for zenny. So if you're in search for zenny, grinding is the best method. So how to grind? You just go to the NPC, choose your NPC, any NPC which gives you a lot of money, you find it easy to kill that NPC. Go up to it, stay in base form, okay? Don't go super saiyan or something like that until you're like too weak. If you're too weak, like level 40 or level 30, then you can go, actually level 40 and level 30 can't even go super saiyan. But if you're level 50 or 60, you can go super saiyan, but it will decrease the amount of zenny you earn. Key Masters gives you 150 zenny, then I think Super Saiyan gives you the 350 experience, and the other guys, Evil Saiyans, the Evil Magians, and the Evil, not Evil, the Kickboxer Wrestler, whatever they are, they give you 200 zenny. So yeah, that's kind of good. But the best two guys for grinding is the Key Masters and the Super Saiyans. Now you must be saying, bro, the other guys give you 200 this zenny, why not farm them? Well, I don't farm them because they are too strong and you can't just kill them in your base form. You need to be Super Saiyan, and I want to extract the maximum amount of zenny I can get. So I mostly do it with Key Masters or the Super Saiyans. The Super Saiyans are too easy to kill. You can just spam on them, but they take a lot of XP, the key out of you. So the third method is the quest sequences. There are a lot of quest sequences. The first one is Yamcha, then I do Vegeta, then Piccolo, and then I do the Supreme Kai of Time. That's it. I do this on Earth, and if I'm on Namek, I will do Frieza, the Frieza quest, the Racing of Border, and then the killing all the Ginyu Force guys. So that's on Namek. Yes, I mostly do. I don't know exactly, but in space I do only Beerus, because that alone gives you a lot of XP, so I don't go for any other quest. If you want, you can go. That's my quest sequences. And yeah, also the Orodian quest, in which you have to kill the Orodians, and the Rogue Namek quest, I forgot, and the Asteroid quest. Yeah, I do this in the space, and then in future I do mostly the Goku quest and the and those guys, which in future are in near the Key Master's place, and then the I legit forgot all the quests, because I haven't visited the future. But whatever, I'm gonna end this video right here. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to smash a like and subscribe for more content, And if you have any ideas on which I should make a video, please, 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 please drop a comment. And though if I find it interesting, then I will definitely discuss it. And I'm going to bring a few guests on my channel. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope you have enjoyed. Until that, I'll see you again in another video. And bye.